My name is maiden name meant Christensen. I was raised by my grandparents, both great-grandparents and grandparents who I was back and forth with. My grandmother, my great-grandmother, well, Manio Manio is her name, she didn't speak English, so I learned my Dakota language since I was a little baby, able to understand. That was my first language. And then when I got older, I went to school, so I learned English. I know the two languages, the English language and the Dakota language. And I'm fluent understanding, talking, I could talk. There's times that I mispronounce words, but I understand everything that's said, you know, because I was raised that way. And so it, like when we're at functions with the elders, when they talk, I understand everything. And when I'm asked, sometimes I mispronounce words. At one time, my grandfather, he was my great-grandfather, and I asked to borrow a couple dollars from him. I was going to a movie, and I was going to tell him, tomorrow I'll pay you, but the two words sound together, Chichukta and Chichutikta. I said the one where I was going to shoot him the next day. Instead of saying Chichukta, I said Chichutikta. My grandpa looked at me, great-grandpa looked at me and said, uh-huh, that was an old Dakota word for Minsa. There's times I mispronounce words like that. But anyway, they all laughed at me and told, you know, Grandpa will never give you money again because you're going to shoot him, you know. And I, oh, Grandpa, Grandpa, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say I was going to shoot you tomorrow, you know. And there's things like that, you know. And there's a lot of words I could pronounce right away because we were in school and didn't hear, you know. Only when we go home and, like, ice cream, we get that once in a while. And I asked my grandmother, I said, Kunshi, Banzopi Hachi Dekta Chahamshana Hawachi. I wanted candy, I said, and I couldn't say ice cream. I said, and Naku, I said, and I know they say lick the ice cream, so I said, Naku lick lick Hawachi. They all started laughing at me because I couldn't think of it the right way. And there's things like we, our grandparents, you know, correct us, and but the way we say it, they laugh at us because, you know, that it wasn't pronounced right. But we used to have a lot of fun. I do. I have my uncle, he's 95 years old, and I've been recording him too. And he speaks the old Dakota, you know. We have the modern Dakota now, things are made up, so I always go to him and talk with him. He's the oldest on the res here.
Is that right?
Yeah, he's the oldest. He's 95. We just lost one maybe about 4 years ago. He was 101. And then next is Papa Saul. Everybody calls him Papa Saul. He's right now he's in a home. Hopefully they'll bring him back home here, you know. So that's what you were talking about, and I miss him because I'm always talking with him daily. I go and visit him and I talk with him daily about long time ago and our old Dakota. He speaks Assiniboine Sioux too. He knows that language. And if you listen good, you understand our language, you understand it. It's kind of hard to understand, but my Papa Saw, he speaks that too.